Guru Brahma, Guru Vishnu, Guru Devo, Maheshwaraha, Guru Sakshat, Parabrahma, Tasmai Shri, Gurave Namaha. Namaste viewers, welcome to Jnana Degula channel. In this session of this video, we will discuss the importance of Guru, or rather, is salvation possible? What is the role of Guru in the process of salvation? But before we go to the details, I request you to please like, share and subscribe to my channel. Thank you. Now, the Hindu traditions, Hindu sampradaya, Hindu dharma, attaining moksha or salvation, in English what we call salvation. Salvation is not the equivalent word of moksha anyway. So moksha, that is the liberation from the cycle of birth and death, is believed to be possible only through the guidance of Guru, rather through the guidance of Guru. Guru leka etuvanti Tyagaraja Swami, Guruvina Gulama Naguva Tanaka, Dorayadanna Mukuti, all these kinds of sayings, all these great sannyasis, all these great people have said about Guru. Now, the role of Guru, or the Guru, is very highly respected in Hindu philosophy. As I chanted the shloka, Guruhu Brahma, Guruhu Vishnu, Guruhu Maheshwaraha, Guruhu Sakshat Param Brahma. He is nothing but the Param Brahma. So, because he is the one who provides spiritual knowledge, he is the one who guides us, he is the one who helps us in practices to reach, to attain liberation. So it is a very, very most revered, Guru is most revered. We will discuss on two, three issues here, two, three points. The Guru as a guide to self-realization. We will see that, how it is. He is seen as someone who has already achieved self-realization. We have achieved the qualities of a Guru in our previous sessions, previous videos. Now, he is seen someone who has already achieved self-realization and he has some deep spiritual knowledge. By learning from a Guru, by under the guidance of a Guru, a seeker can benefit from the Guru's wisdom and experience. Here, the Guru helps the disciples, the shishyas, understand complex spiritual teachings, because he would have undergone all these kinds of exercises, experiences. He is in a position to make disciples understand more easily. He would help them in practicing meditation, and he would also help in overcoming ego, ignorance, attachment. All these things are very important. All these things are key factors in achieving moksha. The second aspect is removing ignorance and illusion. Particularly the Hindu philosophy and this Indian philosophy, ignorance means avidya. avidya is what keeps people bound by the cycle of rebirth, cycle of death and birth. If you remove avidya, you are liberated. Ignorance, avidya. So here, the guru, the teacher is like a light in the darkness who will show the correct way, who will show where you should go. Because you are groping in the dark, you don't know where to go. Guru is the one who helps you in finding the direction, proper direction. It helps, this helps remove this ignorance and leading the disciple to the truth of this divine nature, the own divine nature. Now by dispelling ignorance, the guru helps the disciple see their oneness with Brahman, see how he is related to Brahman, or how he is Brahman himself, Parabrahman himself, that is that ultimate reality. And this understanding is essential for liberation, and this comes from Guru only. So now the teachers or Guru's role in different paths to your moksha, paths to one's salvation, so like moksha we will call it as. Moksha is rather a more keyword which can be understood. So there are several paths. One is called as Bhakti Yoga, the path of devotion. Here the guru guides the disciple, guides the shishyas, guides the pupils in cultivating love and devotion to God. The first step, love and devotion to God, helping them realize God within and beyond themselves. So he helps them understand that God is within you, God is everywhere, God is all all pervasive, all everywhere he is. Next, in Jnana Yoga, another the path of knowledge, the guru teaches the disciples to use his wisdom to make himself, to put himself into self-inquiry, inquiry to understand the nature of the self. This helps them achieve some kind of a direct knowledge of the ultimate reality. Now there is one more path, that is the yoga, karma yoga. Karma means path of action, where you have to act. And you have some karma yoga, raja yoga also, jnana yoga, bhakti yoga, all those kinds of things are there. Here, karma yoga is path of action, and raja yoga is the path of meditation, you can call it as, where you meditate. The role of guru is to instruct the disciple in selfless service. This is one thing. Ethical living. This is the second important thing. Morality, all those kinds of things, whatever we call it, righteousness, all the things that come under righteousness. And inner discipline. Inner discipline means you should have kaya, vacha, manasa, everything pure. You should not have thinking one thing in the mind and then acting in another way while doing the karma. All these kinds of things. They all should synchronize. Kaya, vacha, manasa. Kaya, things that we do from our body. Vacha, what we spell out. And manasa, what we think in the mind. All these three things should synchronize. And it should synchronize in a righteous way. This you can call it as loosely some inner discipline. This purifies the mind and prepares the disciple for some kind of spiritual awakening. So, how do we get all these things? This is through total surrender to the Guru's guidance. You have chosen a Guru, you have chosen a right Guru after a lot of research and other things, you have come to know that a proper Guru, which we have discussed in our previous sessions, who is a perfect Guru. Then afterwards, you should totally surrender to him. Surrender to the Guru's guidance. Because traditionally, the disciple is encouraged to surrender to the Guru's guidance, which means you should follow the Guru's teachings with total faith, total dedication and complete belief in him. Totally you should believe. Through this kind of surrender and then service, the disciple often gains spiritual insights and experiences that lead to moksha, that lead to liberation. So these are some of the points which we thought we will ponder upon in this video. So to conclude, moksha is ultimately an individual experience. It is not somebody you can go and then buy from a shop or buy from somewhere. It's only an individual experience. You should experience yourself. Here the role of the Guru is in guiding and supporting the disciple's journey is important. There are several paths, spiritual paths, you know, emphasizing that a qualified Guru, that is important. Guru, qualified Guru, can be useful, can be essential in helping seekers realize their true nature and attain liberation. So, with this explanation, we will conclude this session of our video. I hope this was quite interesting and quite informative. Please like, share and then subscribe to our channel. Please post your comments and of course for the benefit of the viewers, we have put all this whatever that we have discussed here in our description box also. Thank you.